whether streetcars will Kansas City will add streetcars to its downtown will now be decided at your mailbox. A decision is made to skip adding the issue to the November ballot and instead asking downtown voters to request a mail-in ballot between now and October 2nd to be returned sometime between October 30th and December 11th. The question asks whether Kansas City should add a 2-mile streetcar line between Crown Center and the River Market, funded by a 1-cent increase in the sales tax inside the new downtown streetcar district that was approved earlier this month. It also asks for a tax increase on assessed valuation of commercial and residential properties in the downtown district. So why this mail-in approach? Do streetcar backers not think they can win if it goes on the November ballot, Lynn?
I think they can win no matter what. But they did do very well with this mail-in strategy for the first election, which authorized the creation of this district.
But it does seem like an unorthodox approach, though, for such a huge issue.
It definitely is.
And this is a $100 million project.
It definitely is. And this would provide about $75 million to fund the bonds that they'll have to sell to build this thing. You know, there are two arguments. One is have it at the polls, make it available to everybody who lives downtown. Again, this is not an election citywide. This is only for people living in the downtown district.
Not everybody in Kansas City, Missouri will have a chance to vote on this.
We have voted so many times on light rail, Nick, I've lost track. It doesn't pass citywide. But it's downtown, mass transit, fixed rail often does poll well. I think they think it would have passed even in the November ballot. But the November ballot's going to be a very long ballot. It's the presidential race. This way, you'll get people who are very interested and focused on streetcars alone.
So this is only going to be about 5,000 people living in the downtown area. They can have a chance to vote on this via mail.
And let's call this what it is. It's a slick political maneuver to suppress the vote. If it goes on the November ballot, it's going to have that politically murderous word tax on it. And they may or may not win in November if everyone who's qualified and is going to go to the polls is going to go. It's going to be higher turnout. So now it's only highly engaged people who are going to go, and they're probably backers of the streetcar. This was meant to suppress the vote for a tax.
Is that how you see it, Eric?
This is a very interesting point, but I see it as, okay, if I drive down to Union Station, why would I park my car, get on a train to go 7 blocks? If I'm in my car, I just drive to where I'm going. I don't understand how we're using so much political capital and clout on a train system to go 7 blocks when we just saw what was going on in the neighborhoods. And I do want to back up and say one thing real quick. One of the things with the citizen survey that doesn't show everything.
We're not going to have time for all of that. We are out of time. We have so much more we could be doing on this program, but that's all we have. Eric Weston of The Call and Stacey Cameron of KCTV5. Lynn Horsley of The Star, thank you so much. I'm Nick Haynes. Have a great Labor Day weekend from all of us here at KCPT. Thanks for spending part of your special weekend with us.